We want to.
Please select a landing.
Probably just land at the command platform because I just want to. Have a wash, get all the blood off us. That was, you know. Hit me here. Time to put all those guys down. But, you know, had to be done. We lost a lot of men. Some fine men and women that died that day.
Stop! Snake! Well, that would explain it. Sorry. Guess I've been away a while.
Shouldn't be such a stranger. That's a bad example for the men.
Yes, I know. You've told this before.
And he gets pretty lonely, too.
Do I have to go to every bloody soldier on the base to raise morale? Honestly, I've only been gone like 5 minutes. All the big pass posters have gone down. Ooh, money. Yep. Is there a guy around here? Yes, there is.
Welcome home, boss.
Stop morale increase. NFL, go and increase morale, because for some reason, we have to. Don't mind me, I'm just, you know, slowly set to death.
Boss, now our guys can rest in
peace. Thank you for what you did with the diamonds.
No problem. Over to that platform. Talk to the men there, raise some more now. There you go.
Thank you for stopping.
What's up, boss?
Increased. Oh, I didn't have to do that. Hello. I'm an idiot. Didn't have to go down the ladders. Ba-ba-da. Nope.
Got time for a mock battle, boss?
Nope. Do not.
Let us know if you need combat support.
Will do. Is there anything to do here? There is not.
Whatever supplies you need, just let us know, boss.
Will do. Okay, next platform. You're raising morale by just walking past people.
Thank you for taking in those animals, boss.
You're welcome. Oh, that's a fuck. We have got an awful lot of anti-aircraft guns. Yeah, definitely like that. Awful lot of them. Okay, anyone on the fourth? There is at least one person. No, we shall talk to him.
How about expanding the base, huh, boss?
We're in the middle of doing that. No, he didn't have anything to say. No thanks or anything. Ungrateful swine.
Boss, will you train with me?
Oh, okay, fuck. There you go. There you go. I trained with you.
Boss, we're ready to develop new equipment. Boss!
Okay, time to call the helicopter. Pick up.
Please select a landing zone.
Roger. This is B-Quad. We're arriving shortly at LZ. This is B-Quad. On station at LZ.
Yeah, stuff more like Peach. You happy ocelot? I don't think there was any of us, I found this new mission.
Gaining altitude.
I wish I could salute back, actually. I want to do that. I want, you know, like a little button that I can, salute back to the troops. You know, just like, right. Like, hold down the left click. Click the L3. Click that. Salute the troops. It only happens only on Mother Base, though. That'd be awesome. They're all saluting me. It's a bit impolite to not salute back. Kind of a douchey thing to do, actually. I mean, yes. They're there to, salute first, right? I just want to check the mission list.
Please select a mission.
Pitch dark. Total stealth. Yeah, eliminate the infected. So yeah, I didn't have any other options. Right, okay. So, you know what? Let's listen to what happened in the,
symptomatic colleague, I found myself making my way up the stairs to this room, and I am not alone. Everyone who's infected, we've all come up here wanting to get outside. I know full well I mustn't leave, given the possibility I'm infected. Yet, I can't contain this urge. I feel inside me, like the alcoholic who tries to make any excuse for one more drink. Every step I took up those stairs filled me with this sense of bliss. I still have all my wits about me. It took no time at all to rewire the electronic lock and open the emergency exit. Then, just as I was about to set foot outside, I finally realized what was going on. This desire for freedom is not my own, but that of the vocal cord parasites inside me. They want the ravens to feed on us, pecking us to death, attracted by these sweet secretions. They have mutated to facilitate this. The sweet smell is powerful enough to attract even a species with such a weak nose. So, before the parasites take complete control, I must. Most of the staff in here are already infected. At least, everyone I've looked at is. Infection with this parasite causes a high fever in the pharynx. I have modified a pair of night vision goggles to react only to this temperature range. With these goggles, you can identify who is infected. Other infected will, like me, feel compelled to make it outside. If the ravens get their meal, they'll head for land next. That cannot be allowed to happen.
Well, here we go. Let's find out what actually happened.
The idea of the vocal cord parasites was that they'd only copulate once exposed to a specific language over time. But the parasites infecting our men in the laboratory laid their eggs straight away. The larvae were eating their lung tissue almost immediately. What kind of mutation was it?
Those who were infected and cured still carried the vocal cord parasites in their throats. They were still there, but the males had been rendered female by the Bolbachia, and copulation could not occur, so we thought. But it is the Bolbachia that mutated.
Not the parasites?
You remember I told you the Bolbachia attempts to maximize its number of female infected hosts?
Yes, hence the male-to-female transformation.
Precisely. But other Wolbachia strains use different methods. Cytoplasmic incompatibility, killing the males, and parthenogenesis.
Parthenogenesis? Aphids. Aphids use that to reproduce via females only.
Very good. The females lay their eggs without a male present, creating clones of themselves in explosive numbers. Parthenogenesis was originally a means for an organism to take maximum advantage of abundant resources by increasing its numbers. Certain strains of Wolbachia forced this to occur, to create more and more infected females.
And that's why our men develop symptoms in the blink of an eye.
Wolbachia causing parthenogenesis is common in parasitic wasps. Of course, the Wolbachia I introduced to your men did not have this characteristic.
Oh, it mutated.
But I believe the mutation, whatever it was, caused it to force parthenogenesis in its host, the vocal cord parasites. The Wolbachia we used to prevent egg laying became the agent of limitless reproduction.
There's something else. The symptomatic infected in the laboratory all wanted to get outside, even knowing there was napalm waiting for them out there. You said the parasites made them act that way, but parasites controlling humans, is it possible?
Yes, it is.
Parasites altering the host's behavior is a common occurrence in the world of nature. Long ago, the vocal cord parasites had this ability. But even I never foresaw they might control humans. Until I heard the things your man said.
You mean the researcher on the top floor? The bit about, I'm not a snail.
Yes. Among parasitic worms, there is a genus called Leucochloridium that uses snails as intermediary hosts. As you know, snails prefer dark, gloomy environments. But once parasitized by Leucochloridium, they desire to be in the light. And that is not all. The parasitic worms thrust themselves into the snail's antennae, making them swell to abnormal size. The snail, meanwhile, frantically wiggles its antennae as the parasites squirm inside. The swollen, wriggling antennae soon resemble caterpillars.
I don't get it.
It is so they can be eaten by birds. Leucochloridium needs a bird as its definitive host to breed. They require their snail host to be snapped up by a predator. So they make the humble snail appear to be a delicious caterpillar and lead it to somewhere in open sight.
So you mean the staff trying to get outside
was so the birds could pick at them. The parasites altered their mental state, making them crave higher places and to be outdoors. I can only surmise that both the Wolbachia and the parasites mutated. Before the ancestors of the vocal cord parasites infected humans, their hosts were birds. What we saw in the laboratory was some throwback to that time. The parasites attempting to make birds their intermediary hosts.
It sounds insane.
A praying mantis that is host to a parasitic hairworm will dive into water and drown itself, just so the hairworm can lay its eggs in water. Rats infected with Toxoplasma gondii lose their instinctive caution and run right up to cats. Just some of the many ways parasites control the host.
But we're humans. Surely our minds are too complex for that.
Not necessarily.
I thought just the same. Free will is what makes us human. So it never occurred to me that the parasites could be controlling the symptomatic. But the mood, the will of a person can be easily affected by the balance of their cerebral substances. Take the toxoplasma I mentioned. It does infect humans, and it is thought the infected develop a more reckless attitude.
But to think that mutations occurred in both the Wolbachia and its parasite hosts.
Your observation is most apt. Both mutations occurring at once indicates the presence of a powerful mutagen.
Nuclear.
I see.
Nuclear.
Keep working on narrowing down.
Radiation. We had radiation at the laboratory, didn't we? Anyway, I just realized there's someone I missed to go to because we rescued a wandering mother base soldier. So let's go and talk to Paz because we have a new piece of something for her. So that's good. Isn't it? Yes, I see you all agree with me. That's good. I know I've just been here, but you know, this is still quicker than going across from platform to platform. Well, that's the game. No, go. Hey, D-Dog. You are by far the best dog in games at the moment. You're just so useful. You're not training. Well, you are definitely fitting the mood at the moment, aren't you? So, mother base, staff resources. I've got some more rewards again.
Staff assigned.
Good job.
Welcome home, boss.
This is gonna get flagged.
Now our death will shine on forever. In peace.
That's a bit of rebel yell. Rebel yell? Is it rebel yell? With a rebel yell. She cries more. Come on. There we go.
Oh, Snake!
Hey, Paz! We have something for you, don't we? Do we?
What is it, Snake?
We have another photo! Let's see how your brain copes with this one. Probably not well.
Chico, I wonder what he thinks of me.
That'd be quite a feat.
I have not seen him lately. Maybe he is angry.
Oh, I guarantee you, he is not angry at
you. Something I'm hiding from Chico. Or I thought there was. It was.
Yeah.
But... And then I... No, that is not right. But I am an angel of peace. I am a student.
Yeah, she's starting to twig that she was working for Cypher, I think.
I'm sorry, Snake. My head hurts. Could you let me rest?
Yeah, will do. So here's all the photos we've gotten so far. There's Paz and Mr. Miller. There's Professor Galvez, I think it is. Paz, Dr. Strangelove, I think, maybe, Oswald. Strangelove is dead, so, you know, he's dead.
Gaio Pinto.
Gaio Pinto, indeed. There's Paz having a nice day. She's caught some fish. It's a sunset. That's Peace Day, I think it is. And there's a cat. Not sure where the cat came from. This is gonna get flagged, but I like Rebel Yell. Gonna get flagged. I might as well have the good bit in it. We have prizes. We have prizes, everyone. That's really not a lot of fuel. Okay. Combat deployment. We need fuel. Your mission, everyone, is to get fuel. Fuel, fuel, and more fuel.
Please select a mission.
25,000. There we go. Damn it.
Unit dispatched.
There we got 4 troops. Okay. All right. Helicopter pickup. I think we're gonna do one more side mission.
Roger.
That'll be it.
This is Pequot. Arriving shortly at LZ.
Good job.
Good dog.
This is Pequot.
Good dog.
On station at LZ.
Yep. Up we go. Sorry about that. Oh, attacking from cover. Quick die, reflex mode. Effective range. And other stuff. Set up list. Do we have... We have another... Ooh! Eliminate the wandering puppets. Oh, that's a new one. Intel agent extraction.